He forgot he was playing a Redea deck.
You've talked enough.
Why do I kick you? I drew all of my golds. I feel like I want to kick some of these to find, like, larva. Just to get rid of larvas in round one. I want this later, not now. That didn't really help.
A taste of morphine, is it?
Crazy. Running out haunt. I want round control. Somewhat expensive way to get it. But I have way too many Deathwishes. And I don't want to make this Karen too big.
My loyalty is to Imperial coin after the face.
Shoot Redea, put a single Tongue Banner in deck. Okay. I don't mind a Nearing for the Selena, right? Not like I need the Nero. Banshee to become spying. He copied it and we yoinked it with Maruna. I would need something a little bigger so that I can consume with the Vargas this turn, but
you do the Emperor proud.
Seems fine. Heat waves me as the Hyrule. This is only 8 because I lost the Banshee. Do here. Nothing gets ahead without a leader charge, except Heatwave. But Heatwave doesn't get ahead on the Galenus. Like, do you hear the Magna Division? Probably just makes him play a Bronze, right? Can I just play... Let's, like, do this. Not leader charge. Eh.
showered with Imperial gold.
Getting his defenders cool, I guess. So there's no more Deathwish value. I could Heatwave Desert Banshee, gets ahead, it's not very good. I can play this, it ties, there's no Deathwish value anywhere. Just see what he does. This makes the Ruehin a lot worse. Wave leader charge works. It's probably worth. He's playing Thirsty Dame. There's a ball coming. But if I win round one, that doesn't matter. Didn't I heat wave a 12? So do I not want larvas because they get copied? I don't know. Whatever. I want to force out the ball. This game became very weird. I don't know. I might have threw. Morning song. Actually, I have no consumes left. I have one Bargus, okay. Just a Nero Fiend. Sort of don't hate that. Just commit to the bleed.
I know the truth. I simply want you to admit it.
Now it's second De Niro. But even not drawing the Bargus, this is fine.
The senses can be fooled easily.
Everyone has their secrets. Everyone.
Look at this beautiful, beautiful hand. I'd rather have the Bargus than one of these. It's a little worse.
Yes, sir. As ordered. What is it you want? Push on! No mercy!
Spooky.
I shall be your eyes, my lord.
We win. Yeah, that might have been an overcommit round one, but I didn't want to lose round one to assimilate. May have undervalued my leader charges slightly. Yeah, it was. All the rules being broken at the same time. I want this later. I don't know if I care about it round one. I want a larva. Why did I kick Ruxa? I guess this is fine. Sort of got a curve. I'm on blue. It's a good amount of missing golds. Okay, can we chill on politics? I will start timing people out. It's not really the place for those kinds of discussions. Oh my god. Either disconnect or don't. Split photo. Aspect. Yeah, I mean, feel free to talk about it in Discord. That's fine. Fill our hearts with wrath. I don't want to jam the haunt. I might have to, but I really don't want to. One nice thing about Fiend is instead of having to look and carefully count how many Deathwish units are in my hand for Haunt, I can just look and see what's boosted. Yeah, I get it. That's why I didn't, like, immediately stop it, but it's one thing to answer a question and another for, like, a discussion to start. This is gonna be a disaster, isn't it? If I take the heat wave, I won't have a Getty or a Draco Turtle Antsy. Aside from bleeding. The turtle. He's not killing the Tromother. Ugh. Gwent is to blame? No. Why would Gwent be to blame? Pretty sure the teams are mostly separate. I feel like if anything, Gwent would want them to release during Gwent downtime rather than release around the same time as an expansion. It's an axle. Next turn, I can like a Nero for Catacan to push more. Get an extra point on the Werecat. Gwent is on the scale to really factor into when they release Cyberpunk. No, but I'm sure the Gwent team has their preferences for when they would rather it be released. Not that they have any say in the matter, but I think it's hard to say that it isn't better for Gwent for it to release during the downtime rather than competing with an expansion. I guess I could just go for Detlef. Karen's pretty good next turn. Just keeps up another good turn of reach. Probably no Cyberpunk in Gwent. Not really the same flavor. So if he has Heat Wave for the Karen, that works. Hopefully he doesn't have Heat Wave for the Karen. Good. It makes it harder for like non-heat wave cards to take. I guess I kind of wanted that Noon Wraith, huh? For the second Deathwish. Accept the trade. Kinda doubt it though. Pretty dead if I don't try.
I can help you if you wish.
A poison beaks like a poison arrow heads.
Okay, I've got Larva, I've got Baroxa. Don't really want two Baroxas. Find an Nero. Larva into Baroxa into Foglet into Vargist. Maybe fit Werecat in there somewhere if we want. Karen. Maybe this will go better. We're on blue again. see if having a larva opener helps us not lose uneven. Okay, so Purify is Defender without Dominance. That's important. See you, Redarin Ann. Have a good one. Thanks for stopping in. Just jams the turtle. Ugh. Scary. 3 points per turn with the priest.
Accept our sacrifice.
Eight, 9, 10, 11, 12. Catechan into Vargas and pray. It's not super scary. If I heat wave the turtle, I lose the Geddy answer. How many points is Geddy worth? Isn't Geddy also like a billion? Because he's gonna have preachers. Oh, hey. You win round one. That's way better. I was not expecting that at all. Like, Geddy's worth more combined with Draco Turtle, for sure. Because you get value on the Mardro. But even just like Geddy with bonded creatures. Each Alk is worth 10. At least. Try to push out the scary stuff and save leader plus Detlaf for round three. I don't have the Purify, but he can't gun Defender here because of Manticore threat.
Come on, let's go. Time to face our fears.
Or I just Manticore that. Don't think I can complain about that. So there's the Defender. If I can just let him play the scenario and then just pass to it. Go for Detlaf instead of Ruehin. Look at his leader. Ruehin's better if we're playing this round with Viper. But if we get Ruehin, it's might let him jam Geddy, depending on what tempo he has. Whereas this forces him to commit or lose card advantage. Or in this case, both. So now he has no defender access, he has no turtle access, he has a Geddy, and we have Heat Wave for the Geddy. This should be a win. Taskmaster shouldn't matter anymore. Can lose, but I don't think we will. It's probably Ruehin before Bruxa. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, we gotta do this first. Yep, might be a Nero for Harpy. Taking a 50-50 to break up creatures doesn't seem awful either. But it delays the Ruehin a turn. How many alchemies does he have? Can't be that many. I mean, plays Ruehin. He's playing more consumes than a typical Deathwish deck. Oh, I shouldn't lead that. That was dumb. Werecat.
Sure, you can pet him. Long as you don't mind losing an arm.
Let's get my thrives here. Before Ruehin, because Ruehin's 4 per turn. Brooks is 1 thrive. Yeah, Ruehin's just a fun deck to play. It's got a bunch of different things that it can do. The Heartbeats make it feel not quite as bad to have too many consumes as well. Yeah, the deck can do a lot of different things. Missing the Aniro. No, I'm not missing the Aniro. I'm missing Larva. Probably okay. This deck is Magpie's list from the open. You can get the deck list here. Yeah, you usually want to Heatwave Ruehin. It feels bad to Heatwave Ruehin, but it's usually correct. Depending on how much other tar removal you have. Heatwave, right? I can sort of try to deny ones. Oh, you're just killing engines. Better. Kill archers. It is only a 6. I'd rather Heatwave an AA target. Don't want to lose this round. Ugh. I don't know. Just do like this. Plays kind of hard into the tar removal. These revs are all fine. They're not doing anything. Manticore? Yeah, sorta. You can't really. It's gonna vary from game to game. But I mean, luck is the thing you can't control. So it doesn't really matter too much. In general, better players seem to gravitate towards the top. The same people keep winning. The second harpy. I have to use the leader to get the thing. Or do I just have the other consume for the Ruehin? Harpy is 3 extra points with the harpy egg, but 4 extra points by consuming the Ruehin additional time with the Bargist.
Destiny is unswerving. Cheated.
For king! It will not for be. Country!
Can't complain. Can you deal with a shielded archer? Interesting. So I know one of his cards is an archer. If I just take the heat wave on the Rev and commit for a 2-0, is that even necessary? This is just 8, right? Would I kill Ramadan? Powerful, powerful Maruna. But we have ones on our board anyway. And you can just play a soldier to bring the Ramadan back for free. We win. Wow. Connection problems. He's going through a tunnel. This shouldn't matter. Maybe I remove like bleeds, but I'd rather find larva. I just played the starter deck through, like, the whole campaign. Yeah, just play, like, Scythemen. I think you eventually get a card called, like, Reinforcements. Just, like, play Reinforcements plus Scythemen and win every battle. Make it the new draft mode. Seems cool. I'm looking forward to trying that out. I spent, like, an hour reading their, I don't know what you want to call it. They like dev blog for it. I think I posted on YouTube if you're curious about anything specific.
Hey, listen here. Listen well.
Kraken, eat me girly. Look in here.
Play this and get some thrives. Maybe Workat's important enough later. This isn't worth doing in round one, but... Also, putting my Thrive unit melee... or putting my Thrive unit ranged against the longship... Not advised.
Don't you pester me. Night. Just one morsel.
Play dwarves. Yeah, I played a bunch of dwarves. That worked pretty well for me. Would recommend. So not really sure what's going on here. He hasn't played any golds. This could be Lippy. It would be weird if it was. Pretty sure it's just some strange looking warriors deck. But I think I'm going to push it regardless. Might actually just be he might be Lippy.
Give him no rest, no reprieve.
The all in seems all right. Can, like, force... Ideally, just, like, force him to play the Lippy. Going well. Just playing this magpie. Doing better for us than the commando's magpie. Probably. Seems worth playing. That Igni. Igni doesn't exist. So we win. Poor guy. Poor guy.
Pride is all we've left.
No larva again? Huh. Got Celeno. I can... Fiend, Bruxa, Ruehin, Celeno, Celeno... Nero Karen? Maybe just kick the Bruxa. Kick the Bruxa might be correct. Wasn't something that I even considered. My least favorite deck to go against? I don't know, just like decks with random gacha cards. Usurper. Depending on what I'm playing, it's sometimes Usurper. That's okay. I have a lot of carryover here. There's Protector gone. So it is Feign Death later, which I'm assuming he's playing. I'll just see this. I mean, he's got a Dunkle going. This isn't the worst thing ever.
If I'm to die, I'll do so sword in hand. Time for you to die, Dwan.
Okay, cool.
Humans to the sea.
So he's gonna get to resolve feign death. Can be my dry pass card. I don't know how much of his carryover he lost. I wasn't counting the dunka buffs.
You'll wait for signal. Till then, don't budge. I shall save all your
friends. Then, yep, that's all his carryover. So playing the larva gets waylaid. Playing the werecat gets waylaid. I could a Nero for haunt. Don't think we'd lose after Neroing for haunt. I don't think we need it anymore with this feign death gone. This is just much safer, right? Get my Deadeye. Does. Or I can larva leader. Drawing to two Bargus. I played the Nero though. I mean, what does he have left? Nothing, right? I also don't have anything. As long as I find a Bargus, this should be better. Possibly fine. I mean, there were two consumes, right? It was just two Bargus. Both on nothing. How did this deck end up doing?